How's your football game, bub?
Grandpa's nice about things. He doesn't, you know, whatever I do is good for him.
Do you make it?
Yeah, I made it. That's why it melted the product. Oh, yeah. So you're going tonight? What do you got to work tomorrow?
Same thing, I got to work.
Wow.
They have all week off.
All week? Wow. What are you going to do? Going to travel?
Schoolwork.
Oh, that's right. You're back in. These are broiled for 10 to 12 minutes. Okay, guys. Anywhere we can find. You're going to have a. All right, whatever.
Where is this? It's got a cutter on it.
I'm just going to move this.
It's got a certain taste to it.
It's raw meat.
Is your father like that, man?
Oh, gosh, yeah. Grape leaves and the cheeses and the breads and the bouilli, which is parsley.
Should I put some more bread in?
No, sit down and eat.
One time we tried something that was real good. Cilantro with lime or something. It was really good. I can't find it anymore. I don't know where I bought it.
See, dear, your homemade lasagna is wonderful.
That's really good.
It is good.
Well, I got up early and cooked the macaroni. The lasagna.
You and Marie did. Right.
Grandpa broke Grandma's toe with the vacuum cleaner
cord.
He left the vacuum cleaner out and broke her toe.
How'd you break your toe on a cord?
I pulled the cord and was wrapped around her foot. There's no donuts in there, Eden. I know that's what you're looking for.
See, I was over in that front room.
They're in there, Dave.
He's vacuuming here. The cord is laying. He's done vacuuming.
No, in the big cupboard.
I come walking out
of the cupboard,
and he pulled the cord lassoed around my big toe.
As hard as he could, isn't there?
And I fell and broke my toe.
Huh. Right there. See him?
Accident.
They're chocolate.
Of course it's an accident.
What are they?
The chocolate ones are right there.
Oh, thanks.
Remember that time that Grandma fell on the bottom of the stairs because Grandpa gave her too much to carry? And she fell and hurt her foot.
That was a real bad thing.
Yeah, he purposely did.
No, I was trying to help her. That was all.
He was downstairs and I was coming down with a big box of something.
Yes, she did.
Oh, I thought it was
Christmas. Me too.
Okay. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear
Grandpa.
Happy birthday to you.
I love you.
Hello, thank you. I'm going to make a cut, and then Emma is going to cut. I'm going to blow it out.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh.
We'll let it bleed a little bit. But I might have to help Emma help me.
Aaron, stop at the vulgar. Okay, making a wish.
Well, I got to blow. All right. Hey, all right. I'm going to cut, and then Emma's going to cut the rest. There we go.
I wish that.
Isn't another year older. I forgot about this.
Ew!
I've got some coffee you might like.
Just think of it as a little extra mileage in your birthday suit.
Jacob.
My hair is growing lately.
Emma, you know where the birthday
is. You want ice cream
is.
And cake?
Yes.
Do you ever run
you want some honey?
No.
Yes. Never?
Eat what you can.
You don't take a shower on your birthday sometimes.
Yeah, but I don't run around.
What if the lady's looking at me and I...
You didn't want to see
me around her
birthday
suit. No, Graham.
Thank you, Jay. You know what I need that? I need that when I work out, when I work at Chiba.
Let me see it.
A nice energy. I need that up at Chiba.
Yep.
Thank you, Jake. I'm good use for that.
Yep.
Next week, as a matter of fact, next Saturday night.
These are exactly what you wear.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Are they strike proof?
You got a.
Yeah,
I don't know if I got
see
the receipt.
You have to read our chart.
You don't have to have a receipt to get a bigger size. For it to exchange it.
But I picked it out.
Did you pick it out?
But those are the good colors.
Grandma got it.
I picked it out last month.
What?
That color you don't have the skid marks on.
Dad, don't say that for your granddaughter.
Oh, okay.
Read it.
What is a grandpa? Grandpa's a guy with a big friendly smile that looks like Herman and Penis sitting there. Who never is too busy to visit a while. Who knows lots of stuff about hobbies and sports, who wears nifty outfits like loafers and shorts. You ever see me with my underwear on?
Yes, Grandpa.
Yeah, do you ever?
Jim.
What? Oh, here. They're my winter shoes.
Oh. You winter?
See, he likes the ones winter. That he doesn't have to pull up right, but they didn't have them like this.
You mean like slippers? You mean?
No,
those
are shoes.
These aren't slippers. These are for outdoors.
You're going to wear them out in the snow?
Yeah.
Yep.
He loves them. His fell right down.
And your socks don't get wet or anything?
No, they're outside.
Well, it depends if you're going to be out.
Yeah.
Like a knee deep. Of course, knee deep.
Yeah, if you're going to the store. No, yeah. These, they're not. They're just
if
shoes
he was going to be wear. Doing outdoor work, yeah, he'll wear his big boots.
Well, I got lots of nice gifts here, though.
So that's good, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Well, thank you, everyone. I had wonderful, nice gifts. Here. Come
on. Saturday. I registered it as Sunday.
I did, too.
I really did.
Okay, let me go do this.
No,
I can't. Hannah, did you know that?
What?
Your dad arrived
here. I'm trying to safely.
His suitcase is missing.
Oh, God.
And the tools.
Oh, come on. Really?
That's bad.
He called us today.
Poor Dad.
Emailed Dad and said, can you help me make some calls? I wondered who he was talking with today.
That's stressful.
Well, yeah.
So what are they going
to
do?
15 hours on a train or a plane.
Oh, I know.
Wouldn't you want to change your clothes, take a shower?
Yeah.
And I put this stuff in now. I think they're all burnt.
What?
Well, they were like cauliflower and broccoli. They're in the oven.
Okay.
They might not be any good, so.
I wanted to, do we have any of those steins?
Yeah, up in the top, on the top.
But do we want oranges?
It's good. It's an 8x10.
Come on. Let me just...
Okie dokie.
Oh, thank you, dear.
All right. So you guys had fun last night?
Yeah. We did. You know what? If you don't want these, I'll put these back on. But if you don't want them, because they're pretty done for.
Well,
you know, you can throw them out.
Yeah.
Ow.
Oh, this is good healthy stuff, Anna.
Oh, is that Brussels sprouts?
Yeah.
Oh, that's good.
Are they is it like just raw vegetables?
Yeah.
They look good to me.
With nothing in them?
No. Put them in this one. When have you ate last?
You just told me about taking care of yourself, Anna. There's some good. Now look at that. Doesn't that look good, Anna?
I think I gotta trade glasses. This thing is heavy.
I know. I'm surprised you would. You thought it was gonna be for Gramps.
Yeah.
Well, that's a lot lighter than the other one upstairs. Mm-hmm. But I got this one here. Yeah.
Kind of like I got this.
Yeah, I got this. Yeah.
Well, cheers. Happy birthday.
Thank you, dear. Thank you.
This is a cold day today, November 15th, and it is cold. Snowing already. So we're all tucked in. Come on in here. This is supposed to be a bedroom, but we make it into our family room. Well, we've had this house since 86. So it's how many years, Jim? 28 years. 28 years. Longer than any other house. And even though we've been here longer, still our memories are on the other houses because of the kids growing up there. So we've had a lot of grandkids here, that's for sure. And this is a cozy room where the kids play and watch TV. And Christmas, it's very, very busy. We have a TV over here, a Christmas tree here usually. Everybody sleeps here. That's like sleeping on beds here, floors, but now they're bigger, so it isn't that much, but still have Aiden here, and he's a delight to us, and he'll stay here and always want pancakes in the morning. So it's been a fun thing, and I don't know, it just, time marches on and things change. Even though we've been here, things changes here. All kind of furniture is different. We have a lot of things. And it was funny because I just told Jacob that I was bought this magazine just last week, December 6, 1958. That is the year that we were married. And I had to buy it for $3 at the Amish country. And it's just kind of nice because I can go through this and I can see everything that I couldn't wait to have for myself. Like the electric fry pan, I got one. A beautiful coffee pot, the blender, iron, toaster, all new Westinghouse. Anyways, this was fun to go through because nothing really has changed that much with people. We're still looking for the newest things and the cars. Look at the old cars, how long they were. We didn't think they were, but now we look back and wow, look how big this is. So it's funny and it's fun to go back and see all this. And it's nice that Grandpa and I are still married after all these years. And we can sit around and talk about all the memories and all the things that we did together, all the traveling we've done, and all the grandchildren. I mean, we have 10 grandchildren, and we have 2 great-grandchildren now. And everybody is all in Rochester now, thank goodness. Jacob moved here. So now we're all together as a family, and it's kind of nice. Okay, here we are in the living room now. One of our favorite spots. Spent a lot of time here on our big TV. We thought that was so great. 7 years ago we bought that. How big is that, Jim? 56. But it's starting to lose its sharpness. But we still have a good time. And this is where everybody meets. And I've got this in my hand because in a few weeks we got to go to New York, and this is what I carry with all the lights on it. It's not lit up now. But I have to direct all the people with us to go to Radio City, and this is what we use.
This is Grandpa's
chair. That's his chair, and this is my chair.
So we sit in the morning together.
It's wonderful.
We read the paper, we have our coffee, we look at the television. Every morning from usually about 7:30 on till after 9 o'clock.
That's right.
So we talk about things and we...
We can talk about old things. That's what's nice about growing old together, because you can talk about the old things years ago and then the things that are going on right now and then the things that are going to happen next year.
And we look at old movies on the TV quite often, and we enjoy them, the ones that were made in the 40s and the 50s. So we do watch a great deal of television, probably more than we should, but we see a lot of educational things. We tape some very good concerts on public television. We just do look at a lot of television, but we get a lot of our education off of the educational stations that are on television.
Okay, we are in the spare room upstairs, which is, it has been everybody's bedroom at some point. Let me see now. When we first moved here, Amy lived here for a couple of months before she went to college. So this was her bedroom. And then later on, a lot later on, Andy and his family came here. And on weekends, the kids slept here and they were bunk beds over here. And Andy was here and, you know, and there was lots of toys and books and all that kind of stuff here. So this has been well-used room. And then after that, unfortunately, Jimmy became to use this room too, and James. And so this was another nice room to be able to come in and call their own and sleep here. And James was here, and James and Jimmy were here probably about 6 months, and your dad, which is Andy, he was here for quite a while too, but Audrey and Jacob were here like on weekends, and of course Christmas Eve and all that.
Yes, this is where I do all of my scheduling for the train trips that we do 4 times a year. My computer that I do a lot of work on that, a lot on the telephone, and I have most of my records are in the computer or in the filing cabinet behind me. I have many lists of people that travel with me. It's close to 300 couples right now. Everything is kind of done here at the desk, but Grandma does a good job of organizing. But most all of my work is done here as far as the train trips, and as you can see, there's a lot of train memorabilia here, the conductor's hats and several signs, a lot of memorabilia on the shelves. But this is where I do a great deal of my work as far as my part-time job running train trips. And starting in January of 2015, I'm going to organize my own business, and I will have my own business rather than be sponsored by a local railroad museum, which I've done for 25 years. So starting January of 2015, it will be my own business under my own name.
Okay, now I'm in the kitchen, and this is the kitchen that I've been using for 28 years. All the Christmas holidays, all the Thanksgiving holidays. I don't think we've ever missed one holiday in this kitchen, right, Jim?
Right.
And all the kids help. James, Jacob putting the bird in the oven. We've had a lot of good times. Audrey doing the mashed potatoes. But summer, winter, spring, it's always here. We always have a good time. Actually, tomorrow I'm having my friends come over for pulled pork, and I'm also going to make this Black Forest cake mix from Germany. So I thought that would be fun. I like to have different things to do, not just the regular kind of thing. So it's exciting. Grandpa's on this coffee all the time. Every day that coffee is going. So it's a big thing. And now I only drink 2 cups, but he drinks most of the day, right, Jim? So anyways, we have a good time here. So why people ask me why I call him Dad, and it started long ago when Jimmy is 55 now. But Jimmy, my firstborn, was born, and here he's got a dad called Jim. And so we started calling Jimmy, the baby, Jimmy. But then he turned into Jim somehow. And then, you know, my husband, Jim, turned into Dad. It was easier for us to distinguish as the kids grew, you know, were born. And it was just easier to say, well, Dad said this instead of, you know, your dad, your father. So it stayed with us all this time. And I like it. It's a loving thing. It's not a silly thing. It's loving. It's right, Jen?
Right. And I call Diane many names, but usually it's Grandma or Dear. And sometimes when she calls me by my first name, it's when she's a little cross with me. That's when I know she's cross with me. And sometimes when I do the same with her. But usually it's Mom or it's Grandma. If someone else is here and I'm trying to refer to her, I refer to her as Grandma.
Okay, and since you said that, I'll say that when you used to call me, what you still do, Dear, sometimes I don't think of it as a deer, you know, endearing thing. I think of me as a deer, leaping. Yes, yes. What do you want? I always think of me as a deer, jumping.
This kitchen is a decent-sized kitchen, but it becomes very small when we have about 1,000 people here. And there really is room for only 2 people to work in there. But the size of the kitchen for 2 people is more than adequate, and it has everything that 2 people would ever want to have as far as working appliances.
And it's a good kitchen, Jim. This big counter is really important. It's a good one.
And we've had guests come.
So it might not be up to date and doesn't have the granite counters that everybody has nowadays, but I'm okay with it. I can still cook good. It doesn't have to be the best. The cabinets are old, but okay. We've been here. We've lived through it. And it's fine with me, so I don't care, as long as I'm healthy.
All right, dear, go ahead.
Okay. Well, we met actually in church, and we went to religious education from high school. We would walk down to St. George's, and he was there too. He also went to church there, and he was an altar boy. And that's really how we met. And we went on our first date at the church picnic. And we went to Seabreeze for our first date. Right, Jim?
That's right.
And we were on the Ferris wheel back then. And he gave me a kiss. And so that's how it started. And we continued with our nice relationship and had a lot of good times. All through their high school graduation, his graduation. Then he went to Brockport for a year.
We were in high school, 1950, and we met in 1955. I was a senior in 1956, and Grandma was a junior. I graduated a year before she did, and then I went to Brockport College for 1 year until Grandma graduated. We'll go ahead and down there.
And then we decided to get engaged in August, and we got married the following April. And Jim was working in New Hampshire for the General Railway Company. So when he came home, we got married. He still had to go back and finish up that job. So it was kind of hectic a little bit, but also a lot of fun. So from there, we had a trailer, a brand new trailer, which we were happy to have. And we were moved down to New York, but we stayed on the side of the
New Jersey.
Moonaki, New Jersey.
And I commuted back and forth. I work shift work as part of my job, which I had to do with Kodak, so I was not home a lot of the times, and there was a lot of the times that things went on that I couldn't be there. There might be Thanksgivings I couldn't be here because I had to work. I worked a lot of Saturdays and Sundays, a lot of holidays, a lot of midnights, and it was put a strain on our family, but we managed to survive it. Fortunately, I only had to do this for about 5 years, and then for the next 21 years, I had a day job with some amount of overtime so that I was here to do the things and to go to the schools and meet the teachers and that I hadn't been able to do before. But the income that I made from working shift work at Kodak helped to give us a life and a nice home, and gave us where Grandma didn't have to work and we had nice vacations, but I was away working the tough hours. So that was a little bit hard, but we managed to survive doing that.
Mm-hmm. We always look forward to going on our vacation in the summer to Cape Cod every single year. And the kids loved it. They actually thought it was kind of like our cottage because we always went there every year. And they still love Cape Cod, all of them.
And our younger son, Aaron, still goes with his daughter virtually every year to Cape Cod. So he's continued the East family tradition of going to Cape Cod for a lot of years. Our first year we went was 1966, and you know, here we are many years after that, and he is still going.
We've been all over, but we always do a fall trip up in Maine or any place that has a lot of fall foliage. And we always do our tube trips to New York back to back for their New Year's and, I mean, Christmas and Radio City Music Hall.
We've been in every province in Canada but two, traveling with groups on a train. We've been in every state in the United States but two. Most of it traveled through by train or sometimes staying there. We've been to Bermuda. We've been through the Panama Canal and places in Mexico. So we really traveled a great deal of places.
We've been to Brazil by ourselves one time.
Yeah, we went
to
Brazil.
It was our 25th anniversary.
And we went to Europe. We've been to Europe about three different times over the years. Well, they come to visit, not as often as we would like to see them, because one of our grandsons now is moved to another area of our county, which is about 20 miles from here, so we don't see him as much. The other grandson lives east of here, about 15 miles, so we don't see the great-grandchildren much, but we do see our grandchildren at least every week. We see at least one of them. They come for a visit once in a while. They spend the night, and sometimes they just come for a few hours to visit them. So we do see our grandchildren.
We enjoy it. We really enjoy it.
I am the oldest in the family now. And Grandma is the oldest too. We're both the oldest in the family now.
77, 76. So.
We're both in reasonably good health, just a little tired compared to what we used to be.
Yeah, slowing down and getting a little easily tired.
Yes.
Especially on our trips, like the New York trips and things like that.
We have very easy living here because all of the outside yard work is done, so I don't have to worry about shoveling a driveway any longer or painting an outside of a house or having to do a lot of the exterior things that I had to do.
But he is very busy with the train trips. Every day, because of the go around the whole year, there's always something he's got to be looking up or writing receipts or whatever for train trips. So that's always busy for him.
So that sort of brings us pretty much up to date. Yeah, it does.
Well, we had probably a lot, and now people are sick. There's reasons why they're not here, so I'm thinking about 16, 17.
Stupid.
Yeah. So now I gotta mix this around. And hopefully that these will rise nice. They have to rise one more time.
1 hour guaranteed items are guaranteed by Christmas.
No camp guaranteed Christmas?
Nope.
Good. Feel
great. Get a 50-inch TV for just $218 this Thursday with a 1 hour guarantee from Walmart. We're testing jeans underwear with a
family football
is coming up. And the blade of the knife always goes in, honey. You know what I mean? So you look at it and see, okay, that's the shape. So it's not burnt, it's just celery. Not that one, it's gotta be the old fashioned. Otherwise that one burns up. It's a, might be in this one, right? Yeah, there it is. Okay, could you just put them like right in here? Try not to get into the bone. Let's see what's gonna cook. Where does it say turkey? Because I don't have my glasses on. Is it way at the top?
Yeah.
Okay. Maybe. Okay, bye, Birdie.
Hey, goodbye.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, but I girl.
there is a bug in my pants biting my
Is this the dark
Oh my
meat?
God.
Is it really?
There's dark meat on their pants.
I don't know. It feels like it.
I think maybe you and Ben will be sitting here that you were over there, but
if I ate anyone anything else, honey?
So I can watch your table meeting.
I have great table meeting.
You want one of these?
My friend, I'm going to say one.
Your Grammy Easton.
500 degrees.
Guys, let's all get seated, and Jesse can say the grace, and then we can eat.
You only get an hour of
Lord, we just thank you for everyone that's here. We thank you for new and old. Lord, we thank you for our health and this wonderful meal that everyone helped so hard to make wonderful. We just pray that we would have a blessed new year and enjoy the day together. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
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 Oh, you look so cool with that.
Daddy's going to do it too. Watch. You ready? Want to see you do it?
But wouldn't you say that was a little bit of a...
It was definitely 20 minutes.
No, not.
It was prep time.
Now, did you go to your aunt's or whoever?
Yeah, we went there. They live in Brooklyn. And we were there for like a couple hours. But I didn't eat anything.
Uh-huh. I need some butter.
Actually, I'd use that.
I need that. All right, I'm going to try Hannah's beets here.
Jesse, you gave us this.
Oh, yeah, I did, didn't I?
There, Hannah,
from where?
From his dad.
Remember, like, I'm going to find a carafe.
Hannah?
Yeah.
The beets are excellent.
I had some more.
They are.
And I don't like beets.
No other animals have eaten. You know, I mean, we
could
be looked at like savages.
Yeah. Well, I won't be. No, I'm just kidding, you guys. I don't care.
Wait, I feed one that doesn't.
No. It's all personal preference. Yeah. You know what I mean? You live one life, eat what you like.
What would the aliens think?
We're going, but the next weekend.
It's hard to imagine like what aliens would be like. Can't think of like, think outside of your own mind.
When you think of this whole galaxy, we're in a galaxy right here.
Yeah.
The Earth.
Yeah.
Would you put on those rutabagas?
Nothing.
You must have put something in them. Put butter in it?
Yeah.
Oh, that's usually you don't. Usually I get them from him. They're really plain. But I like that bitter.
I know.
That bitter taste.
The bitter.
That the butter took it out of there.
The bitter taste.
Mm-hmm. The only thing we don't have is squash.
You know, I almost put one in the oven this morning. We had an acorn squash. I'm like, I'll just... Do we need any more food, though?
No.
I mean, we have a lot of food. What's my name, Gabe?
No.
No, stop.
He loves it.
Coffee. Yeah, Gabe.
This is Aiden.
Aiden.
There you go.
That's Audrey.
What's your name, James?
What's my name?
That's Audrey.
Who's that? Who's that?
Who's that man?
James Wade.
Yeah.
Who's that?
Can you say James? It's not bad, but we have a heater in the house.
The thing with your house is just it is bad. Like your stove should really be.
Even if
in your house was meant to have a stove.
No,
we put it.
Was it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's the way it's designed. Because people years ago in the woods, so they'd have a hole. Right in the ceiling.
It's just hush, we don't turn the furnace, it's too expensive to heat the house with a furnace. As a kid though, we always used the furnace, but I don't remember being cold growing up, really. But now it's
here, baby. Stand up so mommy can wipe off your shirt.
That's out.
Go give hug kisses and hugs to all the
I miss you.
Bye bye, guys.
Bye.
Love ya.
Thank you.
I think it went pretty good when you consider all the people here and all the stuff that we had to do right at the end. It gets kind of hairy, but every year is the same thing, so it ended up really good. My brother was baptized there, my sister, me. We got married there. Jimmy and Barry got married there.
It's a trailer park.
Harper Park trailer park.
And this is where we lived right after we got married in 1958. And this road was not here then, just the railroad tracks on the other side.
And right up on the railroad tracks, that was our first Christmas tree. Grandpa and I went for a walk, and he chopped down a Christmas tree, a little one.
63. It's this one right here, 63.
Right here.
Right there to the right. That's the house.
Look at the fence to the garage.
Yeah.
You bought that, Dad. Yeah. We bought that so the kids couldn't get out and they could play in the garage.
Yeah.
Out in the backyard.
That was a big open porch. It was our first new house, or our first house, as we moved from the trailer here, and we lived here from 1963 to 1968. So it was like 5.5 years we lived here.
Yeah. I remember Jimmy crying. He didn't want to move to a brand new house.
Oh, he cried
on Pear Tree Lane. He leaned up against the kitchen. Why do we have to go? Why do we have to go? He had all his friends here, and it just proved the point that it isn't money and fancy houses when a kid wants to stay in his own neighborhood.
It had 4 bedrooms, and it had 3 bathrooms in the house. And up at the top there on the left, those 2 windows, one was a big, big walk-in closet, and the other window was a bathroom. We had our own private bathroom off of our room. Then the room in there, or the window in the middle of the house, that was another bathroom, and that was for the three bedrooms for the children.
There was Aunt Verna's little lace curtain. Well, we sure had a good time there.
And of course, they made a movie there.
Yeah, the biggest thing was our movie was made there. Or not our movie, but...
a movie.
Fear No Evil.
We used to have oars in there.
And this was just an empty lot, and we played.
We
all
had
the
this
games
lot
outside.
Too. So it was after we left, this got sold.
Yeah.
But this was part of our house. This was a whole empty lot there. So we had a huge side yard.
And this, where these two lamps are coming up, that's how people got down to walk at the pier. And we would, there was times that you could put your little boats out. The kids would make boats and send them out with a candle on them.
The ice flows.
And I think that was 4th of July. But there's the pier way down there.
That was a right-of-way to anybody who lived down here who didn't live on the lake could walk down. Any of the people here could walk down and use the pier. And there's a pier there which is all covered with snow and ice.
Fishing, swimming. And I would lay down in my bed, in my water bed, look out the window, and I could see people fishing with their lanterns on at nighttime. And that was the nicest thing that I remember. It was such a joy to be down here. It's always such a mess. Why did I put this shirt on? Okay, you got it.
That's it.
Until you're all ready. I'm just saying it's kind of.
I know that. But I know that. All right, I'll hold it up. Here, Jake, if you want to put the cardboard under this game, it wants to level it here, so.
See, it's hard because they're heavier than the limb.
It's not hooked on.
He lost his wings, too. But he's still part of the family. He's still part of the family. This is a very, very old... It was on my Christmas tree when I was a little girl. And I think it could be from Germany. But he used to have skis on. Now he's one leg and no skis. And he's very old. And even my sister wants him. And I said, no, you can't have him. He's my house now. So this is where he goes. And I always remember him up in my tree. And he's gonna go right up here and look around. Okay, Santa, you've only been here longer than us. Probably, Jim. Mm-hmm. Probably like 70 years, maybe. Because it was my mother's ornament.
Well, it was probably over 70.
Yeah. Yep, yep, yep. These are pictures years ago when we first went on cruises and then up at the buddy's vacation spot up in Charleston Lake with Grandpa's got his pipe, because he did smoke a pipe. And lots of old memories. This, actually this book is my 50th anniversary. We had at Hathorn's restaurant on East Avenue. And it was really nice. I wasn't surprised. We knew about it, but it was a very nice, wonderful thing to do. And everybody was there, the friends and family and everybody. Aunt Pat. Mm-hmm. Uncle Bob and Chris here. Boy, time flies, I'll tell ya. Olive made a beautiful quilt for us, and it's monogrammed in the back of my 50th anniversary for Dad and I. That was nice. So that was, I love this. I'd never part with that one. And this stuff over here is even older, more rickety. But this is when we went on vacation, when everybody was just little babies, grandbabies. Oh yeah, a lot of memories. There's Jacob right there. Marlene, my mother, she loved parties too. That was her 80th birthday party at our house. Yeah, and all the twins and Barb and Bruce. This crib is so old, it's as old as my brother. And he slept in it as a baby, my sister, me, all the grandkids, all my kids, grandkids. That's you, Jacob, right in here with Audrey. I don't know if you can see that. But really nice. You used to love to lay there in that bed and look at the aquarium out in the, right above you, kick your feet and look at the fish. There's your mom and you. Must have been her birthday. This is up at Cape Cod. Yep. Dad, what was the year of this? The movie.
In our house?
Yeah.
1979.
See how they did that, Jake? With their film, they had to get the white up there on the ceiling. And that's Frank LaLoggia. He was the director. His mother just died, actually. It was in the paper. But they came to our house and were there for 7 days. And used every bedroom, every living room, everything. It was quite a thing. There's my baby carriage. We even used that. There's my brother. We were the head of the neighborhood, I'll tell you. And then we had to go down to Shalott and do that. That's Shalott Beach House there. And these are the call sheets. Who would be coming on, who wouldn't be that day, and what time they came in, and their makeup. It was things that we didn't know about, so it was interesting for us. Actually, Amy liked this guy. He was from California. He did breakaway glass and all this. That's how she got hooked about wanting to be into movies and be a movie star and all that. So that's when she went to Rapa to take dancing and all that kind of stuff. So it was interesting. Let me see, anything else here that was good? Grandpa even had to, and Aaron, he broke his hand and he hit somebody, tell him to get out of our yard when they were filming. Right, Aaron? Yeah, and you broke your hand and you had a cast on it. And you were even in the movie with the cast on. You're the only one that had a speaking part. The speaking part was said, "There's the witch, there's the witch." So anyways, that was interesting, fun. That's about it. And there's the t-shirt that we got. It was called Mark of the Beast, but then they changed the name to... what was the name of it there? Fear No Evil. So that's the end of that. Well, we've had quite a winter here with illnesses and New York City trips. We went to the first trip. It was wonderful to New York. We went to the second trip. That was good. Coming home, I got sick. Grandpa got sick. He got pneumonia, and I got the flu. And I'm saying the big flu. So we're just recuperating now and getting better. Still have a cough. So this is quite a thing, trying to get organized for Christmas. And as you can tell, we have done as much as we could with our gifts and all this, a yearly thing that we've done for years and years. And what would you like to say about Christmas?
Well, I remember Christmases of the past that we've had here when we had grandchildren come here and maybe spend the night, when the gifts had flowed out in the middle of the room. There were so many gifts, and as well as the big Christmas tree, they were real trees. Today, it isn't a real tree, but we had them almost up to the ceiling. We had trees that were so big here, they took up 20% of the room, huge trees. Well, now today, as we're older, we don't have the number of people here, and we don't have as many
presents. No, you don't want to go and lay on your belly and cut a tree down.
That's true. That's I don't want to cut a tree down anymore, but they are big, and this tree suits us just fine. The many years, we've been here for 28 Christmases, and the many things that we've seen, and unfortunately, this was a year that we were sick, and we couldn't do what we usually do, but thanks to Grandma, she put a lot of decorations into our house to make it as good as it can, and if it wasn't for Grandma, we wouldn't have the good times that we have at Christmas, and we wouldn't have all of the decorations that she put together for our tree.
He's looking for a Christmas present.
Oh, well, Jake, you think?
You.
No, I'm looking for no going present. On and on. The Christmas tree, all the decorations that she put it on. This is a quiet night for us on Christmas Eve.
Christmas Eve has always been quiet nights, and even when our kids were little, we would just get together. We didn't get together with other families. It was just kind of reading the story, you know, about the Christmas story,
yeah, about
Santa
the night
Claus.
Before Christmas, we always did that. It was always strictly for our immediate family. Then the next day, which is tomorrow, we had a lot of guests. This year, we're going to our son Andy's home on Sunday afternoon with Andy and Nina, and we're going to have our Christmas Day dinner there with a nice big ham and a lot of family friends, and we look forward to that.
And I even think that Jacob probably would still like to be down in the cave tonight for Christmas Eve. I have that feeling. But since, you know, we're not feeling their best, it's going to have to change till maybe next year.
So maybe next year, maybe it'll change.
All right.
And be a little more festive than it is.
Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Ho, ho, ho. Oh, hello. Merry Christmas. We're here, thick and thin.
You gotta add this now.
Huh. Very nice. Beautiful, beautiful. Here's some nuts for anybody. How you doing, Andy?
Hey, Matt. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. This is Danny, but he's not here, so... should I put Danny over here?
Oh, don't step on that dog.
I know.
Come on.
Amy and stuff, so yeah, put it separate.
Hi, Grammy.
Who's here?
Do I hear Aiden?
Hello, oh, honey. Monkey feet.
You know what?
Mr. Munchkin.
Nice. You know what? You can... well, hello, Buster. You can come out and help too, okay?
Yes, Doc and Bull.
He did?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. Dane, I left Gabriel's in the car.
Well, you might as well get it out and open
no,
it up.
No, when they come, no, when they
there's
come.
There's a little table and chairs.
There, when they come, they won't come.
They did like an 8-gun salute. 3 of them. Oh, really loud. That'd be orange. But it's for those firemen.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
They were
the firehouse on the TV.
That's the West Webster Firehouse, right?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
Yeah, I saw it. Yeah. Several
vehicles and some.
It's right there, isn't it? The firehouse. Wow. The season for the dog is hungry.
I like how I'm saying.
Naughty. How's your car? Well, how'd you get here?
It's my magic carpet.
Really?
Well, that's a, I never heard that word before.
Really?
That's good, a magic carpet. Yeah. I like that.
Get on my magic carpet.
Doc.
Yeah. Get the bone I gave him. Where is it?
Nick, you are dropping it. And I ain't showing it.
Ow, and it hurt.
What
hurts? Hiccups.
Don't blame me. I didn't do it. I'm not giving you a hiccup.
Yeah.
Tomorrow what?
Hi, Greg.
No. No, Greg, did you see your boy?
Nikki, I've got to drop off some stuff after here.
Yeah.
He lives right around the corner.
He does?
Yeah, he lives...
In Webster?
Yep. Lives on Cardell Drive. Just right up the gravel road.
For heaven's sake.
Remember a few years ago?
Yeah.
Would you like some? He's a mad kid on the bus. He can throw something at the bus driver.
I thought you meant my Diet Pepsi.
No, he's good. Yeah, what are you seeing tonight?
Why is it? You got to get a bus driver. I have to stay at the school until... Either
going to
stick
it out of
the bus.
Yeah. Wow.
That was easy.
It doesn't matter where you live. There's trouble that you're not made aware.
We haven't got it in a couple of years now.
Oh, that's a bad one. I like this.
Happy.
Yeah.
And the money. Yeah. It's time to sort it out.
Are you done? Okay. Oh, how nice! Oh, that is so cute!
Yeah, you need one, right?
You don't even have a camera.
I know, I just thought of the cooks in the kitchen.
Thank you!
She laughed, she says, Mom, Mom, these are so foolish. I said, here, you want to get.
Oh, yeah. Very cool. I got
it. Yeah. For you, nice. Go shopping. Me.
Yes, and Carrabba's. We love Carrabba's, too.
Mm, I know.
Any more presents for me? Anybody?
Oh, they really are. You can see the their muscle.
Oh, boy. I
you can see a lot of stuff.
So it is beautiful. Oh, you guys lucked out that.
Yeah, we're wonderful seats. I really just walked in. What was the cheapest seat you had?
Having a good time. Last night, went to bed just before the ball came down.
You went to bed before midnight?
Yeah.
Did you?
Yeah.
I laid up by myself feeding my dog.
Aww. Well, we decided, you know, it's almost over. Let's just go up and watch the rest upstairs.
What did you do then?
So we did.
Just walked into the box office.
Quiet night. I had one long crab leg.
A long crab leg?
Yeah, the king crab leg. Oh, one of them.
What leg?
One leg, because they were expensive, so.
Where was this?
Home, here, oh, yesterday.
Home.
Where'd you get them? The lobster trap.
Oh,
you know what, they're near where you live.
That lobster trap was packed with people.
There must have been
car after car.
They had them outside those spots and skids outside where the gas pumps were. Plus on the inside. People were eggs of all these two Oriental, or you don't call them Oriental, Asians.
Dad, do you want to say anything to him? He's finishing up the year.
Well, Josie will be in the movie now. He is making a movie.
That's what I mean. Looks so great in this movie. Yeah. Well, I don't think
well, it's been a wild kind of crazy Christmas and New Year's because of the sickness all around Rochester, including me and Grandpa, but we're all better now, and thank God we're on our way. Now we got to get healthy. Healthy with vitamins, my Nutrisystem. Yeah, the Nutra. Ninja.
The bullet.
The ninja.
Is that what it is?
Oh.
No.
It's not a bullet, it's a ninja.
Oh, ninja.
But we've used it every day. We've used it. So,
good.
So maybe 2015 will be a better, healthier thing. Hopefully. You know? Get into the vitamins and I just need to walk. So that's it. That's about it. That's what Dad and I are missing is exercise.
I've been exercising my mouth for these
months. I know. It's not doing so good.
Yeah, I know.
Really well,
you know, your dad's got a wonderful walking machine down in that basement.
I know he does.
But it's so, I've tried it, but who wants to?